Warm greetings from TwinTech Academy, Chennai. Today's session will be on A Doctor Before a Court by our faculty, Dr. Samuel Abraham. As per the agenda, now 5:55 p.m., I request Samuel Abraham, sir, to start his session. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, all participants. We are going to hear a lecture on this topic. Actually, the topic's name will be very different, but the meaning is how far you should be very careful while we are discharging our duties. Today's lecture will be more practical in the sense how the matters are happening in a court of law. Many people are knowing you are in hospital related matters. So what we see in the court perspective, which we are going to see today. Without wasting any minute, I want to go to the subject. Normally in a court, because a court, there are different types of court. Quickly, I will summarize, have a small idea about what is meant by court and what business they are doing and what are the authorities they are having. Okay. Now, broadly in all countries, we are having two types of court. One is civil court, another one is criminal court. Broadly speaking, there are so many categories that is different. Okay, sir, what is the business for criminal court? Criminal court is the court where state prosecutes the accused in such a way the accused get maximum punishment for their offenses. Again, I repeat, in all criminal courts, one side is always the state. Don't mean it's a government. Government is different from the state. State includes each and every person in a state and union of India. So government is an agent acting on behalf of a state. So government of Tamil Nadu is acting on behalf of state of Tamil Nadu. So broadly, constitutionally, we always say state of Tamil Nadu, state of Kerala, state of Karnataka. If you want to mention union, central government, we say Union of India. That is a legal entity to sue and be sued. So always, when there is an offense in any place in India, it is presumed that that person has caused an injury against the state. I am in Thiruvananthapuram. I am causing an offense or injury to a person. Immediately, the cause of action arises. And it will be construed as though I have made an injury to the state of Kerala. You can apply this, Bangalore, Lucknow, whatever the place I am causing an injury to other person, because state is the locus parentis for all citizens. So state of Tamil Nadu, state of Uttar Pradesh, state of Haryana, each state is the guardian and parent for every citizen who are living within the territory of that state. So state takes over when there is an offense. I am making a complaint. State takes over and they prosecute the accused. So in a criminal court, one side always the prosecution or state, aided by two persons. One, police, next prosecutors. Police investigates and gives a charge sheet against the accused systematically. What are the charges they have made? And after that procedure, prosecutors take over and they want to prosecute the accused in such a way the accused gets maximum punishment and there is law and order, peaceful coexistence in a state. This is the criminal court business. We are not interested now. Next category we call civil courts. Civil courts, interestingly, there's no state. Before a court, everybody is equal. Government is also equal. Private individual is also equal. Before that, I want to explain. Let us not have an idea that courts are government. Courts are not government. Government is a party before a court. Court is completely independent. And take it from me, a lowest cadre of a judicial officer, magistrate or a munsif is considered to be the lowest officer, then sub-judge, then district judge in a district. Every person are independent and nobody in India can dictate terms to any one of the judges in the judicial side. Administratively, they can be transferred. Administratively, they can be punished. But judicially, suppose I am the lowest category of a judicial officer, nobody can dictate terms as to how to write a judgment in a particular case. They are completely independent. You can visit any court where you cannot find government of court. It is only district court. It is only a high court. It is only Supreme Court. And there is no government involved in the court. Of course, in a district judiciary, we call lower judiciary. In the lower judiciary, the highest rank officer is the district judge. And under him, all the judicial officers are working. And every district court is functioning under the direct control of the high court. No other government. So any judicial officer has two sides. One administrative side, another one is judicial side. In the judicial side, he can write independent findings in any court, any capacity. Nobody can dictate him. Suppose he is a high court judge, he cannot dictate any terms to a lowermost magistrate or a munisif. No. Administrative side, they can give command, leave, sanction, increment sanction, transfer, etc. That is we call administrative side. But judicial side, they are independent and they are only reporting to the high court where we are having portfolio judges. So every district will be controlled by the chief justice of the high court and a portfolio judge. Both are having administrative control over a district judge. And take it from me, high courts are 100% independent. They are not functioning under the control of Supreme Court. Please understand, Supreme Court has no control over the high court. Only in judicially, whatever the high courts are giving judgment, it can be set aside by the Supreme Court. But administratively, the Supreme Court has no link with the High Court. High Courts are 100% independent. And they are getting funds from the Consolidated Fund of India, directly drawing salary from them. Nobody to give salary. So now you take it from me, every vehicle, every material under them is independent and nobody can have control over that. Now coming to the civil side. What is civil court business? Civil court is the court where disputes regarding rights between two or more parties are decided. Here there is no prosecution, no state. And civil court is the court where disputes arising between two or more parties about the rights are decided in a civil court. Now the civil court, the petitioner is going first and he is arraying many people as respondent against him. So normally the petitioner has to pay cost to the court. In all civil courts, the petitioner has to pay money. Petitioner means the man who is approaching the court. Because suppose I gave loan for 5 lakhs to somebody under a negotiable instrument, check or a promissory note, etc. Now, after three years, he is not repaying and I want to get the money. I am filing a money suit before a civil court. Money suit means to recover the money, I am filing a money suit. That means I have to pay nearly 7% of the amount, recoverable amount before the civil court, before it is numbered. That means when I am approaching, knocking the door of the civil court, the petitioner has to pay the money. Not the respondents. The person who took money from me, he need not pay any money. But I am the petitioner. Why? Because I gave money without any consultation from the court. Independently, I gave 5 lakhs rupees. Now I want to recover the money. I want the help of the court. I am asking the court to recover the money. So I am approaching the court with a negotiable instrument and I have to pay cost for recovering the money. It depends upon the nature of the rights to be decided. For example, if it is a declaration suit, it is a uniform amount of 300 rupees. If it is a partition suit, it depends upon the value of the property. If it is a money suit, there is a percentage fixed by each state government to be paid by the petitioner before it is numbered for trial. Now have this mind. So civil court, criminal court, There is another category we call tribunal. What's the meaning of tribunal? My dear friends, civil court and criminal courts are constitutional positions, constitutional institutions where no government, no state can undo it. For example, they are having inherent powers. I am now giving a lecture. So next neighbor, they met with an accident. There is a small baby, 6 months baby. Nobody to take care. Immediately I am approaching and taking the baby. Next morning, I can file a petition before the municipal court in Vellore requesting, please give the custody of this 3-6 months old baby till other arrangements are made. Immediately it is sanctioned. The civil courts and criminal courts, they are having inherent powers. Even though it is not given powers to them, they are having inherent powers. But the tribunal, we are going to see third category, tribunal. The tribunal is a quasi-judicial body, 50% judiciary, 50% non-judiciary. And they are not following civil procedure code as per the civil court. Take it from me, all the criminal courts in India are conducting proceedings as per the criminal procedure code. All the civil courts are conducting their business as per the civil procedure code. Now, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, the same thing is followed with minor alterations. But in tribunal, the tribunal is constituted as per an act of parliament or legislature. So, constitution need not be. Any act can create a tribunal where it is executive, it is a government, it is a state which controls the tribunal, because it is not 100% judiciary. So every tribunal is constituted to speed up because the nations like India, we are having populous country. So we are having more population, suppose labor law. If all the laborers are going to a civil court, the civil court cannot function. To cut short the processes, to limit the representation, the constitution having a provision to constitute a tribunal where speedy trial can be done, which we call summary trial. That means the tribunals are not following civil procedure code. A cut short method is followed. My dear friends, why I am talking about tribunal? There are so many tribunals, we can say. Income tax tribunal. CAT. CAT means state tribunal. State tribunal, SAT. State administrative tribunal. CAT, Central Administrative Tribunal. Labor Court is a tribunal. DRT, Debt Relief, Debt Recovery Tribunal. There are so many types of tribunal constituted by an act of parliament or legislature. For example, if the Consumer Protection Act is repealed by the parliament, tomorrow there will not be any consumer court. There will not be any consumer forum. If the Industrial Dispute Act 1947 is repealed, day after tomorrow, there will not be any labor court or there will not be any industrial tribunal. So, the tribunals are a 50% court and 50% non-judiciary. Give and take policy is being taken. Now, gentlemen, why I am talking about tribunal, the Consumer Protection Act created three tribunals, which we explained. So, the three courts, consumer courts are treated and they are coming under tribunal only. So here, tribunal, you can feel free. The main difference between a civil court and tribunal is, in a tribunal, you need not pay any stamp duty. I am claiming 5 lakhs rupees, I pay a fees of 200 rupees. No stamp duty, no vakalat, nothing at all, no fees for anything, no partition suit, only for a specific purpose, the consumer forum is acting. Within the limit of Consumer Act, they are acting. They are not having any inherent power. For example, for claiming 20 lakhs, I have to pay 500 rupees fee only. If I want to claim 20 lakhs in a civil court, you can imagine 7% of 20 lakhs should be calculated and paid in advance. Only then my suit will be numbered. So that is why it is a beneficial piece of legislation for the consumers to go and approach and get their grievances redressed in a very easy, simple method. Cheap, quick remedy is being taken in consumer, and consumer courts are coming under tribunal. So now you understand the nature of civil court, criminal court and tribunal. Now regular trial and summary trial. quickly I'll say, regular trial means the trial is being conducted in a criminal court systematically as per the procedures given. In a civil court, systematically it is being followed one by one, giving all the rooms for all the parties. But in a summary trial, the cut short method is being followed. All the witnesses are not produced before the witness box in a tribunal. Instead, the witnesses, if they are interested, they can file sworn affidavits. Whatever they want to talk in a witness box, they can give under sworn affidavit before the court, and that will be treated as an evidence. So in consumer court, consumer forum, we are filing affidavits only, sworn affidavits from the witnesses, except in some cases we are producing special doctors, experts to answer any query for the court. So that it would, with that exemption, all the witnesses are filing sworn affidavit and they cannot be cross-examined. These are all the processes that are cut short, and there will be an argument given and then finalized by an award of compensation. So it's called summary trial. In criminal courts, in the magistrate court, if the punishment is less than 2 years, we are having summary trial. All other criminal courts, systematic procedures should be followed without any lapses. 100% we have to follow the procedures, both in civil and criminal court, except punishment. Offenses done under less than 2 years imprisonment can be tried as summary trial. This is what will be a defamation. So, proceedings of the consumer court, how we are proceeding, then we will quickly go. Normally, there is a complaint. Complaint copy is sent to the respondent, opposite parties we call. Not respondent, opposite party, hospitals and doctors. Within 1 month, the doctor has to file a written statement. Dear friends, in the written statement, we have to concentrate very carefully. Normally, when the time pressure is there, the doctors and hospitals, they don't find time properly. They leave this matter to the advocate, which will be a failure for them. My procedure, best procedure is, once you are receiving a complaint, there are so many allegations, because it's a tribunal, they can write anything. And compensation, they can put any figure and add as many zeros as possible. Lakhs, 10 lakhs, 10 crore, anything they can write, because it's a tribunal. No fees is, no court fees is there. So they can write it. If it is a civil court, they will be very careful. You know, politicians, they challenge each other, but they never file any defamation case against their opponents because they have to pay money. No intelligent politician will file any defamation case against his opponent because 7% he has to pay. Nearly it will come to 10%. Who will pay that? Why he is paying? He knows that he cannot win the case. Just lawyer notice they will send. But here, consumer allegations are so many. Number, you receive all the allegations, don't upright. The administrative section has to divide into two. One, what are the allegations pertaining to the treating doctors and medical side? That you have to take down. Don't send all the copy to the doctor. He is not having any time. So take down from that 1, 2, 3, 4. Clarifications regarding treatments given to the patient and ask them to give a proper explanation. Not explanation, not a punishment. Explanation means let them explain why they followed this procedure. Beautifully they will answer that. Then other allegations are there. They say nets are very harsh or generally things. Leave that we can answer it. Now after receiving the report from the treating doctor, number one, first paragraph, you have to talk about your hospital, their main objective, how they are serving the public, how many departments, roughly how many doctors, what is their aim, charity, etc., waiver of charges for the poor, underground, all this you have to give, percentage. And you have to give a full picture, a best introduction about your doctor. This must, because the presiding officer and members may be strangers. They do not know anything. They will be sons and daughters of a carpenter or a fisherman or a farmer. Now basically they don't know what is happening and what they don't know anything about your hospital. So first paragraph, first page or 1.5 page, you have to give the noble causes under which your hospital has been established. How long they are working, how many categories, normally what is the number of OPDs, number of how many beds you are having, how many experts are there, their quality, etc. Second paragraph, you have to give, because we are fulfilling BOLM test, duly qualified test. So second paragraph, when we are talking about the allegation about one department, say gastroenterology or cardiology, you take down the cardiology department experts, their grade, their expert distinctions, how many years of service, professor level man, how many years of experience, okay. How many number of operations are, how many number of such treatment given to the patient is being given by the department in a week or in a month, which will reveal to the court that they are experts. Suppose I am telling a cancer patient, for example, cardio. Okay, per month we are treating 150 cardio patients in our unit. That suits the enormity of the hospital. Oh, so they are duly qualified and duly experienced. That is why people are coming and they are having already a good experience. So it gives a full picture about how much and how much charges you have waived in a year for the poor and the those who are receiving less than the poverty line. So that type of social thing, community service, if you are having, you can explain about the community service. So first, after giving this one, then you come to the third paragraph. Allegations, each allegations, you have to tell the allegation and deny that. As per law, as per the judicial proceedings, if you don't deny any allegation, that means you are accepting it. So the other court will presume that out of five, you have denied four, so one you are accepting. That's why you have to go through the complaint and form an opinion and give it is denied and you have to give an explanation. We will write paragraph answers. Each para, we will give para-wise answer. It will be a repetition, but don't bother about that. You have to state first paragraph is denied and reject. Your claim is rejected. It is not the correct way. Second paragraph, you claim that the procedure is wrong. No, the procedure is correct as per the textbook. This is the doctor we have done. This is the procedure we have followed. This is the proof for that. And we deny and reject your false allegation. Third paragraph. Like that, every paragraph, you have to deny, reject, and give alternative answer, explanation from the report our doctors have given to you. They have given answer, explanation. From there, you have to take down and write it. The next paragraph, a brief description about what the type of disease, what is the type of discomfort, and what were your treatment. One page, you have to give a brief explanation report from the date of admission till the date of discharge. My dear friends, you go systematically, which will give the other party, whoever he may be, that the hospital has done a wonderful job. Plus, don't forget to give proper discharge summary to the patient. You have to talk about that also. That also coming under standard care. You have given a wonderful treatment and discharged him without giving any discharge summary, which is not correct. Discharge summary must contain what are the drugs he has to take. Interval, what is the time limit, how much he has to take, etc., etc. And carefully you have to note, if at all there is any adverse reaction, he has to contact the local physician or any one of the doctor in your hospital. Name, designation, cell number, email address, etc. So that they can approach. This must be given in the discharge summary. Many cases we have won because our discharge summary gives full picture. So put the ball on his court. You are telling amikacin caused some hearing problem, some tinkling in his sound. You are not able to hear properly. Yes, we understand. There is an adverse reaction. But we have given in the discharge summary, carefully, if you have anything, any problem, you can immediately call Dr. So-and-so in the hospital, number, etc. or local physician. But if he has not consulted that, he commits contributory negligence on the part of the consumer or the patient. So you have to write this in this paragraph beautifully. And the last, in the above circumstances, for the facts explained above, we find that we are firm that our hospital and our doctors has not caused any medical negligence or any deficiency of service found in this case, and your claim for 20 lakhs, 25 lakhs, 1 crore, 2 lakhs is summarily rejected, as there is no basis for that. And if you want to continue for any judicial proceedings against us, we are having enough records to prevent that. This is the answer you ought to give to the consumer when you are getting the complaint. First stage. Second stage, same thing. Keep this letter carefully so that this fellow will go to the advocate and he will go to the consumer forum. At that time, this paper is very important, because there you should not take another stand. Once you are giving an answer for this man, take a stand. That stand should be supported in all subsequent proceedings. Till Supreme Court, this will be the basis. So that's why doctors and administrators, when you are receiving a complaint, don't dump the complaint to the treating doctor. He cannot see. See, he will have an agitated mind, because seeing all false complaints this fellow might have written. So he'll be very much, you know, discouraged. That's why I'm telling you, read it, divide into two, and one, all medical allegations, treatment, allegations regarding treatment, you have to send to the doctor 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose there is an operation and there is a complication and you are not able to understand, that the consumer is not, he is also not able to understand, then the treating doctor will be in a position to tell you and inform you why he has taken this method, why he has taken this position. So in OG cases, some uterus will be, by birth it will be a unsized or in a different type of uterus. I heard only today. So some women will have an uterus of a different type where childbirth is not easy. For that, the doctor has to go back to the history, see that, then he has to see the method. So there is a complaint that, having known all these things in the third delivery, why you allowed her for a natural delivery? Why not you go for cesarean? That is a claim by the patient. So here, only treating doctor will be in a position to tell us why they chose this type of treatment. So here we have to give this the way we have to deal with all the complaints. Now, next, very good. Before your court, what are the things? I already explained to you about Bolampitas last class. But however, we will slightly go back. Mahalingam, put the slide of Bolampitas. Yeah, duly qualified. See, I am very doubtful. I am not convinced this type of man. There is a man produced before me. According to me, I am not so familiar. I am not convinced that I am competent. Perhaps my friend will be competent. If that is the case, the stress says, don't touch the patient. New care test, I explained, they lost it. Manio, I want to revise your memory. New care test, 3 tests are there. Once you take the patient, systematic procedures as per the textbook and journal you have to follow. Second, whatever you are giving to the person's patient, it should be recorded in the medical records. And whatever the recorded in the medical record should be communicated to the patient. Whatever communicated to the patient should be recorded. And I told you, perhaps you might have forgotten, all contributing negligence on the part of the patient should be recorded in the medical records. Old generation doctors may not be in a position to record, because they were regarded as a god. So nobody will file any allegation against a doctor. They will not think it off. But new generation doctors, they should be very carefully going to see whether, see, in the particular case I was mentioning about the OG case about the uterus size, the husband is telling, don't go for cesarean now, you permit my wife. So it has been delayed more than 3 or 4 or 5 hours, delayed by the commandment given by the husband to delay the delivery. Otherwise, they might have gone for cesarean earlier. So these are all contributing negligence which should be recorded in the medical record. Please inform all your doctors and medical people that they have to record. I already explained about this one. The patient has to follow. Suppose I am the doctor, I am prescribing 5 medicine. The fellow is taking only 2 medicine or 3 medicine. And the next time when he is visiting, I am asking, why you are not taken? Sir, my son is in California and he told me that the two medicines are not good. So I have taken a decision not to take the medicine. Immediately you have to record in the medical. And the doctor has to take, select one procedure which is being for in force in your location and in the relevant time. So this is a polyam test broadly. And next we are coming to the subject, sir, what type of complaint and what is the remedy for that in a detailed way. So in the American books, they have analyzed the type of medical malpractice. They say malpractice. We are telling medical negligence. They say in their textbook, they say malpractice. Now they categorize five methods to avoid litigations. You know, in America, we are having vicarious liability, a concept in law, vicarious liability. That means if I am working for an hospital, you know, vicar general, in a Catholicism, vicar general is the man who is owning the property, he is the owner. So here, the vicarious liability means if I am driving a car, my owner is sitting backside. When we are going to the Chennai city, unexpectedly I met with an accident. A fellow died. I am the driver. So rash and negligent driving. I am having license, etc. We are having insurance for the car. But rash and negligence, I will be booked under 304A Indian Penal Code. I will be fined. I can be jailed, etc., etc. Now, after that, the legal heirs of the deceased persons, the man who died, his legal heirs are filing a suit against me. You are the man who killed my father. My father was an engineer. He was a doctor. He was a lawyer. So he was earning such money. So you have to pay 30 lakhs for us, because you are the root cause for killing this man. And you were a driver. So you drove the car very badly and hit him and he died. So in that juncture, I am giving a petition before the court. My lord, it's true that there was an accident. It is true A died because of the accident. I was the driver and I was punished in the criminal court. Now they are claiming a civil claim against me. This is all facts, but I drove the car only for Samuel Abraham or for Mamata Banerjee, not for me. If they have not employed me, then you can catch me. They employed me because of their employment. I drove the car. Consequently, I killed one person. So they are the cause for that. Only on their behalf I drove the car. So it's called vicarious liability. So the employees cannot be liable for the act on behalf of the employer. So in India, we are following vicarious liability. In America, they are not following vicarious liability. Even though you are working for an hospital, you are a very, very big doctor. If there is a case, you have to meet the case. And the American court will not give any punishment or any award of compensation against the hospital. They will give an award against the doctor. That's why the cost of insurance is high in USA. And they analyzed four causes, four remedies as to how to avoid litigations in a court, which is also practically applicable to India. Number one, it's called level one remedy. Level one, we call primary. Yeah, next, Maha. Yeah, primary prevention. Sir, what is the primary prevention? Please listen to me, sir. This primary prevention is nothing but the way we are treating the patient and their relatives. Normally, in one of the hospitals, they got a complaint. And he said, I will sue the hospital. And I say, what for? See, the doctors are not behaving properly. What is that? Normally, their words, normally, their behavior, normally, their, body language. Then I ask, why you are so much angry against the doctors? Sir, when my father met the accident, we brought the man to the casualty. Blood is oozing from three or four places. The fellow is dying like anything. And as sons and daughters, we are very much worried about his health. And one lady doctor came with the shoulder bag, with a small smartphone in her ears. "Yes, darling. Okay, darling. Okay. Saturday evening, 6 o'clock. Okay, we will go to the Yelagiri and spend 2 days there. And we will go for honeymoon in Kodaikanal or Himachal Pradesh or anywhere. The way of style and the way of talking, and there's no body language conducive to the casualty department. When people are in a very, very bad shape, two or three patients are in the dying stage. Of course, doctors have every liberty to spend their honeymoon, spend their holidays, weekends, etc. No question about that. But where you are talking, to whom you are talking, can't you avoid this type of thing? It happened. That's why I'm telling you. So here, the patient takes an oath that I will take a revenge against the hospital. He takes a revenge. I will not leave these people. Even there is no negligence or any deficiency of service, they file cases against the persons. So the American book says, first you have to talk very less, talk clearly. Yesterday, a day before yesterday, I heard about a case in Kerala. See, there is a small accident. The patient is unconscious. And they say no treatment is possible. The nurses and doctors informed them, there is no use, he is brain dead, that's all. So the relatives understood dead. You put yourself on that situation, unconsciously, no movement at all. So the doctor says dead, brain dead, they informed the patient. But the patient cared properly about the dead. They took it, they put it in the house for a few hours, they took him to the cremation ground, put all sandal, etc. on him, and about to put fire, the fellow got some movement. The doctors informed it is a brain dead case where we cannot give treatment now. If you want, you can take to your house. But relatives understood wrongly, perhaps, and they say the person is dead. One person is saying dead, then all the relatives say dead. Took him to the graveyard. Now, I'm not blaming the people, but our communication should be very clear, simple, understandable, and all. When you are talking about, suppose, risk, for example, when you are talking about brain tumor, you cannot promise falsely. There are many corporate hospitals. They say, sure, we can come very easily. 99% we can save the patient. No problem at all. Don't say like that. Bone marrow operation, merely 25% is successful. 75% not successful. If you are giving a false promise, 90% or 70%, you are in a soup. And next day, when he is paying money, 10 lakhs, he will bombard you. You fellow, you told me 90%. What happened here? In all your hospital, many people died. You will put many questions in such a way, we will not have proper answer. So, say the condition of the patient as a matter of fact, clearly. Explain risk also. Don't afraid. If you are explaining about the risk, he will not come to your hospital. If he is not coming to your hospital, is better. That does not mean you have to give false promise and attract them to bring him to your hospital, and cases will be more. These are all coming under primary prevention. See, when you are talking to a professional field, when you are talking as a doctor or a technician or a nurse, your language should be measured. When you are talking to your house, in your home, you can talk like anything. This is a saying from Thiruvalluvar. When you are house, you can talk loudly, cheerfully, with all the people. When you are talking, discharging your duties as a professional way, it should be measured. But it should not be the other way around. Many people are talk more in the office and less in the house. So the book says, it should be measured, clear, simple, and your behavior should be careful, risk, you have to explain correctly in the correct perspective. And about the bill also, don't suppress any facts. It may cost 5 lakhs rupees. Tell them. And sometimes you have to explain all the risk. The cancer patient, mostly they will die. For example, I am telling. So at that time you have to say, it is very difficult, but however, we will try to save you. This is the way you have to talk. See, you don't promise that he will be easily saved. We have saved many people. No. In a cancer, don't say all these things. But that fellow will catch you in that one. So primary prevention is behavior. Another word, very important thing is, normally doctors, they should keep proper cordial relationship with the nursing staff and other menial servants. Many cases are filed because there is a confrontation between the doctor and nursing staff and other people. You know, nursing staff are the administrators of an hospital. So doctors must have a very cordial relationship with all the employees who are working in the hospital. Because what I am telling you is, after the doctor has gone outside, nurses will take over. And if the doctor is not having good relationship with the other people, the nurses will say, doctor has operated in a wrong way. This doctor, many failures will be coming for this doctor. This doctor, yeah, he is known for all these things. How many people suffered like this man? Casually they will say, in such a way, it will be overheard by the patient. And immediately, certainly will go to the court. In one case, which has been prolonging more than 20 years now, she came for HRT procedure, HRT, hormone. Now, when they were discussing about that, after 2 years, she got some breast cancer. And the junior doctor asked with anxiety to the senior, doctor, is it because that we gave this medicine, this breast cancer has come? And the professor says, no, not like that. It has no relation with the cancer and the drugs. He answered. But the husband of this patient was sitting near her and he was overheading. And after that, he filed a criminal case, a consumer case, and a civil case. 3 cases he filed because of this. So when we are talking, for you, it will be a casual one. You should be very careful in each and everything. In Andhra Pradesh, they, because of enmity, 3 or 4 persons joined together. They send a lady to the doctor who is a male. They want to beat this fellow, attack the doctor. So when the lady went there and sitting, the doctor is putting some question, that's all. He has not touched the patient. Immediately the woman came out, tearing all her saris, etc. Oh, the doctor has manipulated me. He molested me, etc., etc. He was shouting. And on 4 or 5 people went inside the room and they have beaten the doctor. And he was taken to the police station. The doctor was very calm, quiet. And the police asked, sir, what are the charges against you? You are sitting laughing. Yes, sir, I am laughing. You go and see the camera, which is installed in my room. They say they saw that. The doctor has even not touched the patient. What I am telling, I want to express the time where we are living now. It is not those 20 years back. Each and every step should be measured in an hospital. This is called level 1. Level 2, secondary prevention. As I told, I explained about the records, medical records, contributory negligence, and consent, proper consent. Consent is a different topic. If God willing, we will deal it later. Okay, this is called secondary prevention, about the steps we have to take while giving treatment, writing death records, informed consent, yes, all these things. Second. Third, tertiary prevention. This tertiary prevention is nothing but, as an institution, better doctors and other department people advise the institution to take professional insurance of commission and omission. Take for 1 crore. So every year you have to pay 1 lakh or 2 lakhs and you can forget that. Even any court can give any award, the insurance company will pay the money. And I advise many employers in that regard and I am having one or two insurance companies who are very specialized in this area. So better to get a insurance cover so that your doctors will be in a free mood to do their job in a tertiary prevention. One of the tertiary prevention. Four, cortic prevention. What is that? Cortic prevention is nothing but doctors as a whole join together, have a proper awareness camps, lectures, seminars, workshop, etc. So that it will be communicated to the doctors. Let them also form here in Tamil Nadu, Medical Association of India. The doctors join together. They are having an insurance. So wherever there is a negligence, wherever there is a complaint, they just put this complaint letter to the association. Those doctors who are practicing independently, they give this complaint letter, and they are having a network of lawyers in every court. So their association will take care if you are giving a small money. It's called quartic. Four walls, this four, quart means four. So four corners of law, you are secured and you are saved. Next slide, Maha. Now secondary, sir, secondary prevention, we are having 4 points. Valid consent, don't forget. Proper documentation and consent, which should be proper. Samira Kohli case, I will explain quickly. So it will explain, it's a very interesting case, very recent case. Samira Kohli case, where there was a doctor, lady doctor, OG specialist, who is called Dr. Prabanda Prabha Manjunda. It's Delhi nursing home, and she is a very able OG doctor. Now, in a relevant time evening, our Samira Kohli, she was found about 42, 44 years old lady. She was working in a company as an executive, and she came with a complaint of menstruation problem, irregular, continuous and painful. It will long last for 10 days, which was irritating for her. So she wanted to put an end for this. So she went to the nursing home and she consulted that. So when she was telling this complaint, our doctor got a, okay, very good. We will have a examination. She examined this lady. And she suggested to have a laparoscopy test to be followed in another date. So after 2 or 3 days, a date is fixed and general anesthesia was given to the patient. She was taken inside the operation room and consent was obtained for laparoscopy and laparotomy if possible. It so happened, this is according to the consumer I am talking, patient. Then I will also talk on behalf of the hospital. Now, when it was happening, according to the complaint, they sent another junior doctor from the operation room to get another consent from the mother who is waiting outside the operation room. Eagerly waiting, anxiously waiting. This consent the mother gave, they say, lot of bleeding is going on. It is very difficult to save your daughter, so sign it here. So the mother signed it. And after some time, 2 or 3 days, she was shifted to the normal ward. And the son of the experienced OG doctor who is owning the nursing home, he himself is also a doctor. So he was checking and reviewing all the patients one by one. And when he came to the turn of this patient, he sarcastically informed the patient, here afterwards, you will not have any problem. And the patient never thought like that. Okay, why, what for? And the junior doctor explained that, we have removed your reproductive parts. That's why in future you will not have any problem. What are reproductive parts? Uterus we have removed, fallopian tubes we have removed, and ovaries also we have removed. She became furious. How dare you are doing like this? Without my information, no information to me. Who gave you permission? Unauthorized, illegal. And how you can remove my vital parts without my knowledge? It's a fight. And the other side of the coin is, she is 44 now. There is no law that at 44 you should not have any love affairs with another man. She loved a military man in Delhi itself. You know, Delhi, 60%, 70% of the population is military and navy and air force only. So this is a captain, Itsu. They have already engaged for a marriage, and date is also fixed. Before marriage, this lady wants to clear and have a proper life setting. That's why she came to the hospital to cure herself before the marriage. But what happened is, now she cried and he called her military man, and he came with 4 or 5 people, colleagues, ransacked the hospital and forcefully took the lady to his custody. Now hospital filed a suit, money suit, you remember, money suit, to recollect the money of 34,000 as fees. And consumer, the patient, filed a consumer case claiming 10 lakhs against the hospital. So it's called cross. So they filed appeal, cross appeal, like that. Finally, it went to the Supreme Court of India. Now, in the Supreme Court of India, the hospital explained that, sir, it is true that we have laparoscopy, we got consent, and when she was taken to the operation room, we found that full of chocolate cyst, the endometriosis, full of endometriosis circling all the uteruses, and even fallopian tubes, we are not able to see the fallopian tubes. The cysts are so much and so many. On seeing that condition, the experienced doctor thought that there's no use of any operation or any removal of anything. Better to remove all the reproductive parts. Because it's called bilateral salpingo-oophorectomy, removing all the tubes and ovaries removed. Everything is removed. So that give a permanent solution for the lady. According to the doctor, she is already crossed 44 and menopause is approaching fast, and they have not anticipated there will be any marriage and there will be any desire for her partner. It is there. And the best of the judgment and knowledge, no other alternative is also there according to the experienced doctor. So suppose I am not doing that, what would be the benefit for this lady? For heaven's sake, she will not have any babies. I know. That's why he removed this according to the hospital. So cross examination, etc., it went to the Supreme Court. Now the Supreme Court is, in the issue is whether the consent obtained from the mother of the patient is correct, valid or not. They are not interested about the facts. The question is whether the consent is valid or not. And the court declared that the consent obtained subsequently from the mother is not valid. And the Supreme Court declared that unless there is a danger for a life in the operation room, the patient should be resuscitated, come to the normal stage, put all your problems to her, let her take a decision whether to go for operation or not. You cannot unilaterally take a decision and remove all the reproductive parts. That's the question. But however, they ordered that the funds, 34,000, must be refunded to the patient plus some cost. But they have not awarded any compensation, because on good faith, the lady doctor has taken this decision, not for money, but for the welfare of the patient, interest of the patient, according to her. So even though everything is followed, consent is very, very important. So any circumstances, any consent must be explained to the patient correctly. So in one of the case, in a OG case, again, the consent form was signed and the patient and the lady came to the witness box and declared that I have not signed any consent form. I showed to the patient, this is the consent, this is the signature you have made. She said, yes, I signed, but I don't know what for I am signing. I signed, but I don't know. They put some paper, they asked me to sign. I signed it. And the open court was laughing. And I was sure that award will be given against the hospital today. I asked some time, and in the night I was searching all the records, whether there is any good defense for me. because it's a laughing matter. And she says, English they have written, I have not attended uni high school. I am going for agriculture coolie. How I know all this consent? I don't know. After they asked me, I said, so our consent forms are mostly not in mother language. So it should be translated immediately if not done. Telugu, Kannadam, Malayalam, whatever the language, Hindi, Urdu, etc., etc. Whatever the nature of the patient, you have to obtain number one. Number two, it should be real consent. England says real consent is very important. Real consent means you have to explain to them, let them select what they want. Don't enforce anything. And in the night I was seeing in the consent form reverse side, listen to me very carefully, participants. In the reverse side I saw there is a picture drawn by the doctor and she narrated certain people, certain area, marked certain area and written there something. Then next hearing, I went close to the presiding officer. If you are talking in a very distant place, they will think it's a disrespect. It's not psychology only. You have to study law, but you have to study the judge very important. If you are studying the law and if you are not studying the presiding officer, there's no use. All your case will be dismissed. After all, he or she is a woman, she is a human being. Every human being wants that they should be respected. So after 15 feet, suppose I am telling something, the presiding officer will casually see that. If I am going closer to him, he will be much pleased. Oh, senior lawyer is coming close to us. He respects me. So I went very closer, my lord. I want to tell lord only. No name. It is not America. You have to say, my lord, our doctor has taken extra pain to explain to this maybe uneducated woman, patient, but she has taken extra pain to put a diagram and she marks certain portion to be cut in the operation. Even though she is very busy doctor, she is number one in our town. I am telling like that, whether one or two, who knows. I am telling in the town, she is the number one doctor. She is very busy. But however, she has taken extra pain to put this diagram and explain to the patient. And the presiding officer was so smiling and he dismissed the complaint. If there's no diagram there, my case will be awarded, compensation will be awarded against the doctor and hospital. So these are all small means. Gentlemen, small things makes perfection, but perfection is not a small thing. I repeat, perfection is not a small thing, but small things makes perfection. So here, Samira Kohli case and pictogram were very, very important in our lecture to prevent litigation. So small matters, if you are following all these things, next slide. Maha, next slide, yeah. Before we are going to close that, the American book has shown, don't think that America is, they are not good, very big experts. No, no, they are suffering a lot when compared to our doctors. As I told you, the liabilities only are the doctor there in USA. But here liability is with that hospital. So here only one gentleman has analyzed all our cases in India. Only one man. I will mention his name later after the hearing. So 9 preventive steps they have suggested, my dear friends. Don't forget, please, you are an administrator, you are a nursing staff, you are a doctor, you are what not. But you have to inform. Whatever I am informing, you have to inform to your colleagues and peer group. Rapport. Number 2, rationale. When a doctor is doing something, he should not do it as a mechanical way. Lawyers or judges will call without application of mind. Without application of mind, don't do anything at all in life. So rationale means when a doctor is doing an operation or surgery or treatment, you have to understand, you have to convince yourself whether you are doing the best thing. According to the research given by the medical journals or textbook, etc. So rationale, your method, your procedure must have rationale in doing it. 3, record. 4, remarks. When you are talking to the patients and making a remark, you should be very careful. You should not be very tough man always staring at them very, very serious look, that I am not recommending. You can always be smiling, but your words should be measured. You should be very kind, but you should be very strict. Just like a, when I say, just like our fathers. They are very kind in heart, but show they are very strict. The way, so you have to be very helpful to the patient. At the same time, your words should be measured. And five, risk. This means, I mean what about, when your doctors are prescribed, they say put an R, then they cancel it. So that mark I am talking, is five. So when you are prescribing medicine, don't prescribe any medicine which is not wanted. In that also you will be caught. So prescription should be apt, proper and correct. So no overdosing, and you don't prescribe more medicines without any, because your diagnostic result and your medical decision should be based on the diagnostic result, and according to the result only you have to prescribe medicine, and quantum etc. you should be very careful. Now six, res ipso liquitur. My dear friends, this means the facts will prove the case. What is that? Res ipso liquitur means the petitioner need not prove anything. Normally petitioner has to prove the case. In a civil case, petitioner has to prove, not the respondent or opposite party. But in this case, petitioner need not prove anything. Suppose I went to the eye hospital. There is a problem in my left eye. And I have been taken to the operation theater. They operate in the right eye. For appendices or any hernia operation, left side, I am admitted for operation in the left hand side. When I came from the operation room, my right hand side hernia, they cut it. This we call res ipso liquitur, where sometimes they put the some things, scissors like anything, in the abdomen and close the wound. So here the patient need not prove anything, just he is making it remarks is enough, court will give award. So avoid res ipso liquitur. Res ipso liquitur means the facts prove the case. So don't your let your doctors do not create or do any cases which are falling under res ipso liquitur. Seven, respect. The condition of the patient in the operation room is very pathetic. He has no movement, no talking, just like a dead body. And you are the conscious people there. You are dealing with their body with consent. You are authorized to do, so to say, anything in the body. After all, that fellow is like a dead fellow. But law says you must have proper due respect to the patient as a human being. So respect. And eight, try to bring positive results to the patient. Try your best as though this is the first patient and it is the only one patient you can do. Every patient should be considered as a distinguished person to bring positive results. And nine, risk. I told you, explain about the risk in the company of all the relatives so that they will not go against you. I have had many experience about these relatives. So every person wants, no, there is one psychotic says every human being is having a board in his chest. Please respect me, please encourage me, please help me, please treat me as an intelligent person. That is a board, invisible board for every human being. So whenever you are dealing with patient or when the patient is unconscious relatives, you have to talk to them very carefully, clearly and in a due respect. If you are following all these tests, all these steps to be taken, I assure you that you are having a very good chance having a proper defense, and you can stand before any court of law. You need not worry about the court at all. You can forget about the court if you are following all the preventive steps. In India, I told you about one expert who is a medical doctor. His name, he is actually, I am a disabled to him. I wonder his knowledge. He has made a book, Dr. Jagadish Singh. And there is a lawyer, Vishwa Bhushan. They have written this book. Are you able to see? This is the best book available in India, which analyzed all the consumer cases. So there are many researches are going on about the litigation, what the percentage of punishment, etc. So the analysis is going on. But in India, when compared to USA and other European countries, we are having less. Okay. Any questions? One or two can ask me, or you can send me email. I gave my email. You can write to me. Thank you so much for patient hearing, gentlemen. Very thanks.
Thank you, sir.
We have asked questions in the comments. We have asked questions in the comments. Could you read the comments and answer our questions?
Mr. Samuel, sir, Mr.
Yeah.
Anish David mentioned in a chat box, sir, what about labor case related cases? In which court it will come?
It will come to labor court. We are having a tribunal. We call a labor court, but it's a labor tribunal. All the cases relative to the industrial dispute or dispute between the employer and employee, or the employee and employee and employee and employer, all these cases will come under labor court, under the Industrial Dispute Act. So Industrial Dispute Act constituted labor court and industrial tribunal. So all the cases will go there. But we are going to see the new labor courts where many of the rights given so far to the workman is being taken away. So last we will discuss that.
Yeah,
that also very good. Yeah,
thank you, sir. And another question from Dr. Desai.
Yeah,
is there impeachment in civil cases?
In civil cases, normally we call civil imprisonment. Please understand, in a civil case, suppose in a check case, it comes under both civil and criminal. So 132 section 132 of negotiable instrument, we are filing a case against a criminal court only, against the fellow who gave check. So we are having two options. One, civil court. We can go to the civil court and claim. We can also go to the criminal court under 420, section 420 of Indian Penal Code, where fraud, without having money, this fellow gave check to me. He defrauded me. So punish him. So in that case, if I am going to the criminal case under 132 and 420, the criminal court will hear the case and he can be imprisoned for 3 months in a jail, but it's called civil jail, where I have to pay money for his upkeepment in the jail. So in a civil case, it is not a civil criminal conviction, it is a civil conviction where we have to pay money for putting a fellow under an imprisonment. But normally what happens in a check case before the criminal court is, suppose I gave the check for 5 lakhs and he may put me in the civil court, civil jail. It's a loss of prestige for me. So normally 90% of the people pay the money before the judgment comes. So I'm conducting many cases, check cases in Vellore as well as in Chennai. And normally 99% they will try to settle the money when the proceedings are on. And the persons who are filing the case also find it very difficult to pay money, more money to the jail authorities to keep this fellow under their custody. Otherwise, in civil court, there is no provision for punishing or imprisonment.
Again, another question by Dr. Desai. What if we find cancer? Should we wake patient up?
Again, please repeat.
What if
no, the question is, yes, sir, if we find cancer during laparoscopy or laparotomy, but we have not taken consent for the cancer, should we operate that patient or should we wake them up, or how do we manage?
Sir, you have to resuscitate the patient and tell them these are the things, what to do.
Okay.
Resuscitate the patient.
We can't take consent from the relatives and operate.
No. The case, if there is a possibility of resuscitating the patient and the possibility of informing the patient later, then you have to follow that. What I am telling is, if it's a brain tumor or a very major operation where you find that life-threatening matter is there inside, and if you resuscitate the patient, again, you cannot do the operation. it will be not interest of the it is not due to the interest of the patient, you have to do it, then you can do it, and you should must have a proper justification for that in the medical records. Why you have done that?
Two separate anesthesias are considered.
Your action should be justified.
Okay.
If you have not done that, it will be the disinterest, against the interest of the patient. To that extent, it should be serious.
The thing is, sir, we are not really sure what we are supposed to do. As far as our bosses are concerned, they used to go ahead and do it with consent from the relatives. But I know of two cases where the surgeons have been sued by the patient when they have gone ahead and done the surgery, saying my consent was not taken. One was Dr. Satyanarayana, a cardiothoracic surgeon who operated on a chest wall tumor, and the patient ended up with paraplegia because there was an extension into the spinal column. And another patient who underwent for an abdominal tumor. So that's why I'm asking this question to you.
Yeah, you are very correct in asking this question. In Andhra Pradesh, there was a case where a computer man who is only 23-24 years.
Yeah.
So he had some operation. In the operation team, there was no neurosurgeon.
Yes.
It touched the spine.
That case only I am talking about.
Yeah, it touched the spine. Then the Supreme Court says, when you are having that problem, why not you add a neurosurgeon also in your team? And you know that about 1.5 crores was given to this man. So, unless it is life-threatening, you have to resuscitate the patient, get a consent after that and do it. In Bangalore, St. John's Hospital, a brain tumor operation, the date is fixed, time is fixed, 7 o'clock evening, and the patient is not forthcoming, patient is not able to give consent. So, relatives are not giving consent. Now, doctors were ready, but they have not started the operation. Result, they went to their home. Next day morning, 7 o'clock, the patient died. The case was filed and St. John's defended the case, and the court upheld the decision of the team of doctors that they have not touched the patient because there is no consent forthcoming. The reality is, there are some money, maybe 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs they are having. According to them, if operation is being done, the money will be spent. The fellow dies also, this money can be divided among them, among the relatives. So they have decided not to give consent. The fellow died. That's the root cause for that.
Thank you, sir.
So unless you are having consent, you cannot proceed unless until it is an emergency accident case. That I explained in the first class. Yes. Any doubts, you can write to me by email so that we all can learn more.
Sir, last question. A consent taking for blood transfusion is valid for how many transfusion?
According to me, for a patient, once you are transfusing blood for one instant, for that only it's valid. Next, you have to get another one. There are many cases where the blood is contaminated, cases were filed against that.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. If any questions, our members can write in the form of email or WhatsApp to us. We will see you next Saturday for the next session. Thank you all. Good night.
Good night. Good night. Good night. I'm so happy today.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
God bless you.